Hi viewers, I'm coming to you on the waves of Majesty Christian Television Network. I'll bring salute to you. To you and your noble family, my name is Apostle Helen, dorkenoo. Position this hour to speak the word of God to you. And I believe that you will be surely blessed. As you know, in this very month, we've been speaking too much on divine assistance. Why? Because it's very, very necessary. A time comes when the physical, the natural fails. And then there are certain things you cannot accomplish through the natural strength. So you need to switch over to the supernatural. Hallelujah. The God we serve is a supernatural God. He's a supernatural God and he is always ready to support and assist us supernaturally. So when we have come to a place where we want to throw in the towel, we must always remember that there is a God that performs miracle who can divinely intervene through any means, and he is not limited by geographical location. Let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, it's once again a privilege to speak your word through this network. I humble myself and I thank you for the grace that you have put upon my life to be a blessing to my generation. As I speak, and at the hearing of the sound of my voice, I pray that lives will be touched. I pray that people shall be healed. I pray that people shall be ministered in all their areas of expectation. Let the glory and the honor be given unto you. We implore that you do that which only you can do. And the glory and the honor will be given unto you. We will be careful, O Lord, to give the testimony and the glory unto you alone. In Jesus' name. Joyfully say a big amen. Hallelujah. Angelic assistance is required for us to go to the next level. Angelic assistance are required for us to attain a certain level of height that we need. Angelic assistance is required when you are confronted with an issue beyond your capacity. When you've been locked up in a place and been watched and harassed by the enemy, you need angelic assistance. The Bible tells us in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 12, and let's read. He said, when Herod would have brought him forth, the same night Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains, and the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and the light shined in the prison, and he smote Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hands. And the angel said unto him, guide thyself and bind on thy sandals. And so he did, and he said unto him, cast thy garment about thee and follow me. And he went out and followed him, and wist not that it was true which was done by the angel, but thought he saw a vision. When they were past the first and second ward, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth unto the city, which opened to them of his own accord. And they went out and passed on through one street, and forthwith the angel departed from him. And when Peter was come to himself, he said, now I know of a surety that the Lord has sent his angel and had delivered me out of the hand of Herod and from all the expectation of the Jews. This is the word of the Lord. Peter, the one that was supposed to take the church of God forward came into a place of stoppage, and not only a place of difficulty, but was arrested because of his faith, and Herod was about to behead him. Herod wanted to put him to death because he had already done that to one of the apostles. So he felt that what he did was very, very okay, and nobody challenged him. So Herod now stretched forth his hand and grabbed Peter. So Peter was kept in prison. And Peter was put in a very tight situation. Peter was surrounded by guards of, you know, militants that were ready to carry out the assignment of Herod, which would be to execute him. The Bible said, a night before Herod was about to carry out his act, the angel of the Lord, a divine help, was sent forth down to the prison yard, located Peter at the very room that he was, put all the guard on sleep. And Peter, who was fast asleep because this guy has given up, waiting for his verdict, Peter was quickened. The angel touched him and said, get up, boy, put on your clothes, put on your sandal, and the angel followed him. The angel began to lead him. Peter was walking alongside with the angel to the point that when they got to the iron gate, the Bible said, the gate opened on its own accord. That means the gate opened at its own free will. The gate did not require any person to press some buttons before it opened. It opened on its own accord. And the angel saw Peter through, moved Peter to a reasonable extent where Peter would know that, where Peter would be able to take care of himself. Then the angel of God disappeared. And then the eyes of Peter opened, and Peter realized that what he thought was a dream had become real. Peter saw that he had escaped from the prison. I mean, before he could realize what was happening to him, he was already at a door where the other believers were fellowshipping. What am I trying to say to us? Angels are supposed to do their works in our lives. They are ministering or agents to our needs. They are being called for to minister unto us who are heirs of God's throne. They are called to assist us in the time of difficulty. When we are in a troubled situation, we need to call upon the Lord. And when we cry out to God in prayer, he will send angelic support. The story, as simple as it may have looked in your eyes, or it may have, you know, tried to look as you read this very scripture, it's not as simple as you think it is. Have you ever been put in a place of tight corner? A place where everything shows that you will be beheaded. A place where nobody could come to your rescue. A place where it becomes obvious that you are going to be off in the land of the living. You know, when it has to do with other people, we always think it to be just an ordinary story. But when you fall into such a situation, then you know how hard it looks. And then you will understand how bad it is, and how unfortunate it is, and how you will become very disappointed at the God you have called may have failed you. I am here to let you know that God does not fail. Even if you are going through the waters of temptation that wants to overflood you, God will never fail. If you happen to find yourself in a dungeon where it is as if you've been dumped and forgotten, some people have forgotten you, and some people are conspiring to, you know, disgrace you or to put you to shame, please remember that there's God. Remember that God's eyes are upon the righteous to do them good. Ah, he said, the righteous crieth, and God heareth their cry. He comes to deliver them in their time of need. Sometimes the righteous, they cry and they cry and they feel as if they've been forgotten. It is not the way you feel. It is about the steadfastness of God. It is about the authenticity of the word of the Lord. He doesn't move by our emotion. Do you understand? God moves only by his word. The Bible says God will not forsake us nor leave us alone. So in the time of difficulty, always allow the word of the Lord to minister to you. The word of the Lord is full of comfort. The word of God is full of encouragement. The word of God, it can never be changed. The word of the Lord is the same forever and ever. Whatsoever God said he will do, he alone can do it. God is capable of doing what no man can do. Where the natural strength fails, God takes over. And that is where the supernatural comes in. At a time when Peter felt that there was no more way for him to escape, I mean, the sort of militants that were guiding the prison because of Peter wasn't the small one. They were on special assignment because they know if they do not carry out that assignment, it will cost their own lives. But somehow along the line, I didn't know how they fell asleep. You see, when God wants to help you and God wants to deliver you, he has a way to put your enemies to sleep. He has a way. He has a way. Are you hearing me? He has a way to put them to sleep. He has a way to make, to embarrass them with the things around which they cannot handle. He has a way to do it. God doesn't need the hand of any man when he wants to deliver you. All he wants from us is to go on our knees and cry out to him, is to bring the petition to him, and to sincerely confess that we are weak, but that he is strong, and to, you know, sincerely put our confidence in him, that we know he is confident to deliver. He is competent, I beg your pardon, to deliver us from that which we fear. Hallelujah. Please, I want you to examine it again. What is it that gave Peter the stamina to be sleeping in the midst of all odds? Yes, he could have been very tired, wearied, and he looked up and down. His help could come from nowhere. But he also knew one thing, that if the Lord is involved in his life and God wouldn't want that to happen to him, it will never happen. That means whatsoever happens to you could be the will of God, could be how God have orchestrated it. Are you? Because he is aware of everything that happens to his own people. Sometimes he allows us to go through those difficult times, not because he has forgotten us, not because he has forsaken us, but he wants to get glory out of it. Because if it is at a point where you can always solve it, you can always do it, you can always, you know, use your man, no man connection to do whatever you want, then you will never be able to acknowledge God in your life. So he allows us to come to that level of difficulty so that he alone will take the glory. I pray tonight that you will bring all your burden to him. I pray tonight that you will cast your burden. He said, cast your burden unto me. Cast it. Just cast it. Throw it before his feet and see how God will fulfill the desires of your heart. Hallelujah. God will never put his own to shame. God is too good. I mean, he is too good to the point that he is extremely too good. Amen. There's nothing too bad. There's nothing bad at all that God cannot handle. no circumstance, no situation that God, there's no environment that God cannot enter. No matter where you are right now, and you are being threatened by the opponent, you are being threatened by those who want to harass you, you are being threatened by those who want to shame you, let me tell you, the shame will go back to them. Their plan and their coup will be executed in their own lives. I've seen it happen many, many times. When people will plan against me, it boomerangs on them. Because before they could know it, my God takes the battle over. If you be if you love yourself, stop fighting a righteous person. Because when you try it and you continue to do it, God may spare you the first time, spare you the second time, but the third time he will not spare you. Because he is involved in the affairs of those who love him. He has a way to embarrass the devil and embarrass him to its fullness. Are you hearing me? Herod eventually was embarrassed because Herod couldn't believe. He was wondering, how could it be that this guy I wanted to execute has really, really escaped me? If you read further in that same scripture, few just days, for Herod, who was, desiring to kill Peter, he himself died. He was eaten by the worm. That which he wished Peter came upon him. That which he wished Peter now was the one hearing about the death of Herod. Are you hearing me? Your enemies, you see, what they desire for you will come upon them and overtake them. And you and me will live to see the downfall of our enemies. We will hear the news of their departure. We will hear the news of their closure. We will hear the news of their death. We will hear the news of their departure, their disappointment. We will hear the news of their sorrow if they do not repent quickly. Hallelujah. The angel of the Lord are ministering angels to us. They are angels that have been put to just minister to us. Angels are beings that have been put to minister unto us. They don't come to entertain. They don't come to threaten. They just come to minister to us, who are the heirs of God's salvation. So Peter escaped from that which the devil wanted for him. Peter was brought to a place of safety by the divine hands of Jehovah. Angelic assistant escorted Peter out of the prison. Peter didn't come out from the prison, like the way they normally do here. When they want to release you, they will just release you and pity you. And, put you in a place of pity as if, you've lost so much. Peter was highly escorted. He was given a heavenly bodyguard that took him. By the time he could get to that gate, the Bible called it an iron gate. The iron gate opened by itself. Iron speaks about judgment. It speaks about hard situation. It speaks about strenuous situation. By the time Peter got to that place that seemed like it would never happen, the Bible said the iron gate opened on its own accord. May that be our portion in the name of Jesus. That which seems so difficult, that which seems so impossible, that which everybody is wondering how you will escape from it, may it happen in your own eyes. That you will escape and you will give the glory and honor to Jehovah. That disgrace will not come. That death sentence will not come. That disappointment will not come. That desire and the plot of the enemy against you will not come. The people that he is using, they all and the enemy himself will be disappointed. Say a big amen. And Peter was brought out of the prison. And you put yourself there. And I'm putting myself, helen, ruth, dorkenoo, will be brought, will come out of the prison. Hallelujah. Whatever imprisonment. Some of you listening to this broadcast, you may be out there and you are saying, I don't have any imprisonment. I'm not in any imprisonment. You may not be, physically imprisoned, but you may be spiritually imprisoned. There could be some certain things you are going through, and it has been happening and happening and happening. And some of you are in spiritual imprisonment, which has its genesis from your root. And you've been going through that disappointment, going through that sickness, going through that failure, going through the persecutions from one to another, from one to another, from one to another. If you cast your shadows into your family, you will see that those things have happened to those who were there before you. And now in your turn, it's also happening. Listen to me. Just go on your knees and pray. Go on your knees and pray. Go on your knees and pray and tell the Lord that your story has to be changed. Send angelic help, oh God. Send your visitation. Confound this thing that is trying to make a mess of me. And you will see what God will do. Hallelujah. You will see how God will come. He will speedily come to the rescue of his own people. As he rescued Peter, would he rescue you? As he delivered Peter, would he deliver us? He is in the process of delivering his own people. Can I hear a big amen? That is who God is, and that is what God will do. I give you another example before I close. Angels, they are ministering, they are what? They are ministers unto us. They are to minister to our needs, to give us support, to, you know, accelerate in our speed of achievement. The Bible tells us there was a time that he was preparing now to go. Probably he says that he will soon die, or it could be that he says that his son, Isaac, had grown of age. So Abraham had Eliezer of Damascus as his servant. So Abraham wanted that Eliezer would make a vow so that if anything should happen to him anytime, Eliezer would not permit that Isaac gets a wife among the people where they live, but that Isaac should go back to their fatherland to go and get, that Eliezer would go back to their fatherland to get a wife for his only son, Isaac. So, to his begotten son, Isaac, I beg your pardon. So, the Bible tells us in Genesis 24 about the dialogue. So, Abraham had to bring Eliezer to the point of making a vow that Eliezer must not get a wife for Isaac among the heathen, but rather that Eliezer must go back to their land, you know, the father's land, to go and get a wife for Isaac. So Eliezer vowed. Eliezer agreed and took the oath. The Bible said from verse 6 of Genesis 24 that Abraham told Eliezer, make sure that you do not take my son back there. Abraham said, the Lord, the God of heaven, who brought me out of my father's household and my native land, and who spoke to me and promised me an oath, saying, to your offspring I will give this land, he will send his angel before you so that you can get a wife for my son from there. If the woman is unwilling to come back with you, then you will be released from this oath of mine. Only do not take my son back there. So the mission was that Eliezer must go there and get a wife and bring the wife back to where they are, the present Canaan, where they were. That was where Abraham wanted that Isaac had to abide with the wife. What I want you to notice here was in verse 7, where Abraham said, the Lord, the God of heaven, who brought me out of my father's household and my native land, who spoke to me and promised me an oath, saying, to your offspring I will give this land. He will send his angel before you so that you can get a wife for my son from there. Abraham was so certain, Abraham was so sure that angelic support was needed for Eliezer to accomplish the assignment of getting a wife from the fatherland and getting a wife that would be willing to follow him to the land of promise for his son Isaac. Do you see? That wouldn't have been by a natural, you know, rattling, a natural speaking. It wouldn't have been by a natural conviction. So angelic support was needed to accomplish this mission. The Bible said, from verse 12, then Eliezer prayed, Lord, God of my master Abraham, make me successful today and show kindness to my master Abraham. See, I am standing beside this spring, and the daughters of the town people are coming out to draw water. May it be that when I say to a young woman, please, let down your jar that I may have a drink, and she says, drink and I will water your camels too, let her be the one you have chosen for your servant Isaac. By this, I will know that you have shown kindness to my master. Verse 15. Before he had finished praying, Rebecca came out with her jar on her shoulder. She was the daughter of Bethuel, son of Milcah, who was the wife of Abraham's brother Nahor. The woman was very beautiful, a virgin. No man had ever slept with her. She went down to the spring, filled her jar, and came up again. The servant hurried to meet her and said, please give me a little water from your jar. Drink, my lord, she said, and quickly lowered the jar to her hands and gave him a drink. After she had given him a drink, she said, I will draw water for your camels too, until they have had enough to drink. So she quickly emptied her jar into the trough, ran back to the well to draw more water, and drew enough for all his camels, not even one. So do you see the fulfillment of the prayer that Eliezer prayed in verse 12? He said, God, give me speed. Enable me. Let me be successful in this journey. And if indeed you are with my master Abraham, I want you to make this mission to be very, very successful. After he finished praying, the Bible said, as he was just saying amen, ending his prayer, whoops, a virgin appeared. Beautiful girl who was also related to Abraham. That means the prayer had been backed up by the heavenly assistance. There was a divine, you know, there must have been an angel that stood in front of God, who heard when Abraham was making oath with Eliezer, who saw when Abraham confessed that the Lord, my God, will dispatch an angelic being that will assist you to accomplish this assignment. That angel moved alongside with Eliezer without Eliezer knowing, until Eliezer got to that particular land, and Eliezer got to where he saw the well, and Eliezer stayed close by the well. Eliezer was believing that somebody would come out to come and fetch water, and behold, every prayer Eliezer made was answered exactly the way Eliezer had asked God. The lady came up. The lady fetched the water. The lady gave to Eliezer to drink. The lady said, okay, let me also fetch water for your camels. And she went down, fetched the water, and gave the water to all the camels. Then Eliezer knelt down, and he knew that God had answered. Beloved, can you imagine how angel helped to facilitate this marriage? to make sure that it was the right woman that was found for Isaac. When you get angels involved in your daily affairs, even in the choosing of who will be the right partner, the Lord will, he will send angelic help. He will let you know the very husband that you will marry. He will let you know the very wife that is meant for you. He will let you know the very business that is for you. He will let you know the very school you're supposed to go. He will let you know, and you know it very, very well, and you will not make any mistake. When you get heaven involved in your affairs, you will not make any mistake. Are you hearing me? If this man did not believe that angelic host would have been sent to accompany even Eliezer, do you think he would have altered that word? Abraham believed that there are certain things we cannot do or we cannot get only by our being very, very smart. There are certain things that can never be done until we get heaven involved and we petition to God and we say, God, do it this way for us. Little wonder Eliezer prayed and the answer came so quickly and the wife was found. The ideal wife was found for Isaac. May you find your ideal partner in the name of Jesus Christ. May you find fulfillment in that which God will give unto you. In the name of Jesus, may heavenly guards be released to be on assignment to accomplish your heart desire. In the name of Jesus Christ. You see, because of the heavenly assistance, the journey was being shortened and the journey was made very, very quick. He was able to arrive to the success of the journey very, very, very quickly. May the Lord God Almighty help you in this very month to, accelerate quickly. To accelerate quickly. To get a speedy result in that which is your heart desire. Say a big amen. Sometimes we delay too much in life. We delay too much. Things are supposed to be done so easily become so delayed. But even though you must have been delayed, or even if you are passing through a delay at this particular moment, I pray for acceleration for you in the name of Jesus. That this very month will bring you into your month of acceleration. It will bring you into a place of rest where you will only pray and angels will go into assignment on behalf of you. They will work for you. They will provide for you. They will bring satisfaction to you in your areas of need. Say, I hear you. I bless you in this very month with angelic visit. I've been saying it. Don't take it for granted. You wake up one morning, you will see angelic being in your home. You will see angelic being ministering to you. They are not going to come, with wings in their distance, and you will become frightened. No. They will come like ordinary people to minister. And I pray that when they come, you will not miss them. I pray that when they come, you will not commonize them with your eyes and say, I pray that your heart will be very sensitive and very, very ready to receive angelic help. When they come, they will make lives easier and better for you. This is my wish for you in this very month, for you and your family in all your areas of trouble. Let angelic being be released in the name of Jesus Christ. They are made to assist us. They are made to minister to us. That's why God called them forth, so that they can minister to us who are the heirs of salvation. Hallelujah. I receive that angelic enablement in my life, in our lives. I receive angelic support in every area of our need. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. May God bless you today, and may you be at peace and continue to trust God, knowing fully well that He that have started a thing, or He that have begun a thing in your life, will bring it into accomplishment. Listen to me. You are not a candidate for disgrace. Do not panic and do not fear. God will complete what He has started in your life. And your very eyes will see the good result that you have expected in life. Your expectations will not be cut off they will be fulfilled. Why? Because God is too good and he will do good to you. Be blessed and be blessed and be blessed. I see you again next week by this time. However, if you are listening to this broadcast and you know that you have not received Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, remember, you may not be, you know, partaker of this angelic visitation that I'm speaking about right now. But you can also make this your decision to receive Jesus today as your Lord and personal Savior. Say, Lord, I thank you for who you are. I ask you sincerely to come into my life and be my Lord and personal Savior. Forgive me all my sins and adopt me as one of your sons or one of your children. Help me, O God, so that I will not go into disgrace anymore. I want to serve you with all my life. From today, come into my life and abide in me. Thank you for saving me, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have made this confession with all your heart, you are no more the same person. You have changed. You have become a child of God. And this blessing and this very preaching will be a blessing to you. Hallelujah. Be blessed. And find a living church and begin to attend to that church. However, if you are close to this area, in the Netherlands, in Amsterdam, please, our ministry is based here. We are located in Past Schreweg number 17. Join us every Sunday at 10 o'clock or every Friday night. We have prayer night. It is too powerful and very, very, very enjoyable. From 10 o'clock to 3 at most. We are done. Join us and test how prayer will deliver you from the things that you are going through. I hope to see you there one of these days. Thank you and bye.